I was elected railroad commissioner of Louisiana in 1918. And they tried to impeach me in 1920. When they failed to impeach me in 1920, they indicted me in 1921. And when I wiggled through that, I managed to become governor in 1928. And they impeached me in 1929.
The most famous Louisiana politician of all was the legendary Huey Pierce Long, the Kingfish, governor, senator, and presidential candidate. Exploding onto the scene as governor in 1928, Huey Long set the tone for Louisiana politics for decades to come. Flamboyant, powerful, a professed champion of the poor, with a sense of honesty that was never above suspicion, and which didn't seem to bother most of his constituents.
How many men ever went to a barbecue and would let one man take off the table what's intended for 9/10 of the people to eat? The only way you'll ever be able to feed the balance of the people is to make that man come back and bring back some of that grub he ain't got no business with.
Whatever Louisiana is today or is not, it would be called Huey Long, and he changed it forever.
Who built the highway to Baton Rouge? Who put up the hospital and built the school? Who looked after shit kickers like you? The Kingfish do.
Before Huey Long, Louisiana, perhaps the poorest state in the nation, had been ruled by gentlemanly do-nothing governors, running against the corporations, Standard Oil, and the old gang. Long promised the poor something different. He would build them charity hospitals, give free school books to their children, and end their rural isolation with paved roads and bridges. And he kept his word. It was his creation of this political creed of Louisiana populism that set Long apart.
Kingfish gonna save this land.
Huey Long did so much to change the politics of Louisiana, because what he did was say that I'm gonna get in and help poor people. And he helped poor people visibly. He built bridges. He gave them hot school lunches. That was a politics that politicians after Huey Long learned about. You get in office, you promise helping poor people, every man a king. You get in and you do very visible things for poor people, and you win.
You've got a lot of poor people, and you've got a lot of middle class people who don't have to pay taxes because the big oil companies or someone else are paying them, and so they don't tend to mind what the politicians do with the money. So politicians were looked on as entertainment value, and what they can give the people, what they can give them in the form of roads and free school lunches, and what they can give them in the form of a few laughs.
On the water wagon.
Scalawags don't make us angry. They amuse us. They entertain us. And we come to love them. And sometimes in politics, we come to keep them around. They afford us hours of discussion. Our indignation gland, someplace along the way, was sorely damaged, stymied. It no longer functions. Things which would send other people into rage at some occurrence does not seem to affect us that way. The important thing is that we be amused and entertained.
Every man a king, every man a king, for you can be a millionaire.
That's fine. But
after Huey, a certain pattern developed in Louisiana politics. Periods of flamboyant populist governors briefly interrupted by unexciting, never re-elected reformers. It makes a colorful, if not exactly honorable, procession.
There'll be peace without end, every neighbor a friend, with every man a king.
What do you think about that?
I think it's fine.
1936, Richard Lesh is elected governor. He is later indicted, and jailed for racketeering. 1940, Sam Jones, a reformer, becomes governor. He is never reelected. 1944, hillbilly singer Jimmy Davis is elected governor. He then stars in a movie about his own campaign.
For you return someday.
Huey's brother Earl Long and his populist ticket are swept into office. Their campaign slogan is, "Every man a king and every woman a queen." 1952, reformer Judge Robert Kennan is elected and serves one term. 1956, Earl Long is reelected in a landslide. He is linked to a stripper named Blaze Starr and will be checked in and out of mental institutions till the end of his term. 1960, Jimmy Davis is reelected on a segregationist platform, rides his horse up the Capitol steps, and 4 years later sings his farewell speech to the legislature.
We'll bring a House Bill 222. The code of ethics not far behind.
1964, John McKithen is elected with the slogan, "Won't you help me?" His administration is later rocked with indictments and accusations of mafia influence. 1971, Edwin Edwards becomes the first Cajun governor, travels frequently to Las Vegas, and cultivates a reputation as a womanizer. He serves three terms and is indicted for racketeering.